biggest challenge in interpreting COVID-19 tests is the same as for any diagnostic test, and that is to not rely solely on the test result to make a diagnosis. Several factors play into this dynamic. First and foremost is your assessment of a patient's complete clinical picture. In addition to the patient's symptoms, you want to consider the kinetics of the pandemic in your community, as well as the patient's exposure history and likelihood of having other diagnoses. Likewise, the timing of the test in the course of a patient's illness is crucial. Analytical and pre-analytical factors, such as the type of test and how the sample is taken, also matter. The nucleic acid amplification tests that detect the novel coronavirus's RNA, usually by PCR, are analytically sensitive. They have primers specific to the virus's unique genetic sequence, so a positive test result is likely a true positive. Rare circumstances, such as a reagent contamination, could yield a false positive result. However, the bigger concern clinically would be with false negatives. Evidence indicates that the virus typically incubates 3 to 6 days, with an average of 5 days from exposure to symptoms. Viral shedding starts within 2 to 3 days of infection and peaks at the onset of symptoms, generally about a week after infection. Shedding declines over a total of about 20 days. All this means the timing of the testing really matters. Suppose it's Monday and you're seeing a young, asymptomatic patient. She's concerned that she might be infected after attending a crowded party on Saturday in a community where COVID is prevalent. If tested on Monday, she likely would have a false negative result. But that same young woman tested 4 days later on a Friday and 2 days after she developed symptoms would likely have a positive result. COVID molecular tests also can pick up the virus weeks into a patient's illness. While this result would be a true positive, meaning viral RNA is present, the patient probably would no longer be shedding active virus, so is not infective. As sensitive as COVID molecular tests are, they also can yield false negative results due to sampling variations. The nasopharynx is a key reservoir of the virus, but if a swab isn't inserted fully with the right technique, it might not capture sufficient viral load to test positive. Point-of-care PCR tests are not as sensitive as lab-based tests and could miss patients early in the disease process or those who have milder cases with lesser viral loads. These nuances circle back to considering a test result in the context of a patient's clinical picture. Let's say your community has a fairly contained outbreak, but your patient is a cashier at a grocery store. He presents with intermittent fever and chills, body aches, a dry cough, and he's had it for 3 days. His rapid PCR result is negative. You've ruled out other diagnoses such as the flu, which isn't circulating in your community. A reasonable conclusion would be that this patient has COVID-19. This illustrates when it comes to diagnosing COVID-19, test results count, but clinical context carries the day.